Good morning, students. Myself, Dr. Shiraz Pasha, professor in the Department of Conservative Dentistry and Endodontics, Sri Rajiv Gandhi Dental College. Today, we are recording this video to show you the demonstration of rubber dam and its parts. So, let us go through each and every part. So, this is called a rubber dam template. So, if you can see, it is written maxillary and mandibular. So this is for the upper arch and this is for the lower arch. So when we are selecting each tooth, we can select on individual hole. So this is called a rubber dam forceps. So it has got two prongs here which will hold the rubber dam clamp, and it has got an adjustable table where we can secure the clamp. So the next part is the rubber dam punch. This rubber dam punch is a very important tool where it has got the rubber dam punch table. On the table, if you see, there are holes here which are designated for individual tooth. So the first one is for mandibular anteriors. The second one is for maxillary anteriors. The third one is for maxillary and mandibular premolars. And the fourth one is for mandibular molars, and the last one is for maxillary and mandibular molars. Rubber dam frame, which is made up of plastic, and you have even metal frame which is called Young's frame. So it has got sharp edges which will help in securing the rubber dam sheet. So this concave surface will be facing the patient. The next part is we have rubber dam sheet. So the rubber dam sheet is available in different sizes, different colors, and in different thicknesses. So the different colors, we have all fancy colors nowadays. We have black color, we have blue, have green. Rubber dam sheet has a dull surface and has a shiny surface. So when we are using on the patient, we are going to see to that the dull surface is facing the operator. There are different thickness of rubber dam sheet where we have medium, heavy, special heavy. So this is a medium sheet. Apart from that, we would require a floss, dental floss, for securing the clamp and for passing the floss between the interdental contact. Something called rubber dam clamps. So each clamp is designed for different purpose. Now clamps are available in winged as well as wingless clamps. So I will just show you what is a wing, and all these are wing clamps. So this is a wing clamp. This part of the clamp is called a wing clamp. So the parts of the rubber dam clamp are, you have a bow, you have the beaks. These are the beaks of the clamp. These four beaks are called the, these four pointed edges are called the beaks of the clamp. And this is a bow. And these are the holes for encircling the floss.